Guess what? I finally passed the exam with low passing rate.
No way! High five! You are a lucky dog.
Lucky dog.
I tried so many times, but I just couldn't pass it.
I'm not the one who failed you. Why do you call me a dog? It's so rude.
Hey, wait. Lucky dog means lucky. What's wrong? Why are you so mad at me?
It's time for Palfish Show!
Hi guys, welcome to our Palfish Show. Lately, we got a lot of feedback from parents, also through the observations of your classes. We noticed that there are some terms not suggested to use. Most of the students are ESL learners at Palfish, and most of the parents, they're not good at understanding the expressions you use during your live sessions. So we don't want to cause any misunderstanding or misperception, and then they give you bad reviews. So here comes the top 5 words or phrases or sentences not suggested to use.
Number 1, monkey.
Look, teacher, this is you. Is it beautiful?
Oh, it's me. Yeah. You're so sweet, little monkey.
Monkey, am I a monkey?
In Chinese culture, describe people as animals or as any other creature is not very polite. Try now use this in your class to your students or any other people.
Number 2. Dum dum.
Okay, Jim. 1 plus 1 equal to?
1 plus 1 equal to 6.
Try again, dum dum.
Dum dum? That makes dumb. Dad, my teachers call me dumb.
What?
Dum dum directly translated into Chinese means dumb. I know this seems normal in a normal conversation, but if you're teaching a student or leave the comments for your class, it won't look very good. People and parents and students will not appreciate that. Try to not use this word.
Number 3. Whatever.
Hi, Jim.
Teacher.
Read after me.
Okay.
Class.
Class.
Listen. Class.
Glass.
Okay, whatever.
Whatever seems like you don't care about what the student was talking. The students might lose their confidence or interest in English. Try to not use these words too much.
Number 4. Chubby.
Hi, Jim.
Hi, teacher.
Oh, did you get your haircut?
Yes, I did.
It makes you look a little bit chubby now.
Chubby?
Mm-hmm.
Does that mean fat?
Hmm?
Fat? Dad, my teachers call me fat. Dad!
What? How dare you call my son fat? He's not fat! You're fine, no worries.
I know, Dad.
No worries.
Sorry.
I know.
We know chubby is the soft way to describe somebody's body shape, but in Chinese culture, it is not normal or common to describe anybody or judge anybody's body shape. So try to not talk about or judge any students or any other people's body shape.
Number 5. Silly.
Okay, Jim.
Huh?
Let's act like a tiger.
Tiger? Tiger
is a tiger.
Tiger.
Oh, you silly boy.
Silly.
You silly. You very, very silly.
Silly, directly translated into Chinese, still means stupid or dumb. We all know silly is not the way how you say people sound. It's kind of you saying the student was being fun or having fun or being funny. But if the parents hear it or put in a dictionary, that will translate into your student is being stupid. So try not to use this word in your class to lead any misunderstanding.
Dear Palfishers, I think you probably come up with better ideas, or if you have any suggestions, leave your comments below. We would very appreciate it. And if you like the video, I hope you like it. Give us a thumbs up. See you next time. Bye.
Palfish!